Vijayalakshmi Prasanna Bidari, IAS Municipal Commissioner of Kolhapur, enhanced its reputation. Media got an exclusive interview with her.
You enhanced the reputation of the Municipal Corporation after taking over as Municipal Commissioner of KMC.
I joined the KMC in July 2011. And when I joined, one of the major issues which we had faced was about the solid waste management in the city was very poor. And then we had issues with the sewage treatment in the city. Apart from this, the roads which are being built on BOT basis were being completed. So there are a lot of issues which, you know, which are very basic to the city which were not addressed at that point. So our priority was to complete the roads. Road work, almost 49 km of road length was completed under BOT with IRB. After that, we set up on the mission of completing the sewage treatment plant of 76 MLD, which with almost 70% funding from Government of India. And we also have started a new project with Rockham, which we are yet to finalize, in the sense that bidding is completed, where we are making a waste to energy project, where nearly 2 megawatts of power is going to be produced from the 165 ton of waste which is produced in the city every year. So what used to happen was this waste was being collected, and today there's no place to actually dump the waste. So there were no means, or right now this technology is available to actually convert it to either RDF or to energy, and we got a good bid on BOT basis. So a lot of new things happening. Apart from this, we took a major decision about providing water to the city. Till 2045, we planned the requirement for the city, and accordingly, 440 crore project has been put for approval for Government of India, where 90% of funding is going to come from Government of India and the state government, and 10% funding is going to be put by the corporation. So that will ensure clean water supply to the city of Kolhapur till 2045.
Okay. My next question would be, in the last 3 months, Kolhapur has witnessed to murder, and there is a serial killer on the prowl. Is Kolhapur the next crime capital of Maharashtra?
The right person to answer this should be the SP of the place. Yes, there are some issues recently, some people from belonging to North India were beaten up, and there are some other issues which are happening in the city. Yes, see, that doesn't reflect well, because see, Kolhapur also wants to project itself as an industrial hub, because there are a lot of steel industry, there's a lot of foundries, there are a lot of industries which, which are based on sugar cane and its products and things like that. So while projecting ourselves as an industrial hub and also projecting as IT city, today there are a lot of companies which have more than 200 resources working for them. So if we want to project ourselves as a IT city or as an industrial hub, definitely you should have a cosmopolitan outlook. And the city must be safe. That is a primary requirement. And I'm definitely sure the people who are in charge of the law and order are working towards it. There has to be tolerance. There has to be more tolerance.
Monsoon is almost proceeding from Maharashtra. How has been the rains in Kolhapur, and has Radhanagri Dam been filled up to its full capacity?
Yeah, this time, almost 110% of the rain of the year has come in the month of July. That means, our average rainfall has crossed, and then there's been heavy rains in Kolhapur also. We almost reached a flood situation where we evacuated a lot of families. Almost 20-25 families were evacuated, even in the city. So the city is covered by Panchganga River from all the three sides. So that's always a threat to the city. But it, on the other hand, it also ensures full water supply for the city throughout the year. At the same time, monsoons, it creates a danger for the city also. But thankfully, the water has receded in time. The Radhanagri Dam was also full. Many of the gates, all the gates are open at some point. So that way, luckily, because the rains receded for some time, we didn't have a flood situation. But we are prepared for that. And this time there's an exceptionally good monsoon throughout the state. So after a drought, we are experiencing a heavy monsoon. So again, but crops can be affected, things can be affected. So even a heavy rains also has its own negative effects. So, but right now, thankfully, there's no flood situation. That way, things are getting back to normal.
What news of LPT after it is imposed?
Yeah, LBT, we were one of the earliest corporations to actually implement the LBT system, doing away with the octroi. And we also implemented the capital value based system of property tax. Even before Mumbai Corporation took up this, Kolhapur is the first corporation in the entire state to take up a capital value based system for property tax. That increased our revenues by almost 30-40% in the property tax revenues. Similar with LBT, we came across a lot of opposition. People had a lot of misconceptions about the LBT thing. But LBT thing is actually far more better than the octroi system, because even I believe the octroi system was quite draconian. Because, you know, here it's a voluntary system where people have to declare all their assets, in the sense what materials they brought from outside the city and how at what rate they brought out in the city. And there's a percentage of the, it may be 0.1%, 0.2%, which they have to pay the corporation as a local body tax. This is a much simpler and easier system, but I don't know, there are some misconception which was created. And in the first phase in 2011, we actually had to go through a 16-day bandh in Kolhapur. And there was a lot of opposition, and there were court cases against the LBT in the court also. And we actually waited through all that with a lot of patience, and you know, only thing we used to call associations, explain to them things and understand their problems. And we also took personal hearings of around more than 6,000, 7,000 traders. You know? We are actually taking individual hearings with them so that we can sort out their issues and we can tell them how to file the returns every month. So that with that patience, we could close to 70 crores is what was recovered in 2011-12. But we could increase it to around 85 crores in 2011, in last year. And this year we kept a target of 100 crores for LBT. That means we will be almost reaching the same stage at which we were at octroi. It takes time in LBT, but I'm sure as and when people understand the voluntary system has its own benefits and there's more freedom and also, you know, there's less interference by, you know, bureaucrats or the clerical people in the entire system, they'll definitely accept the LBT system slowly.
What is the status of cleaning of Panchan Ganga River, as MPCB officials had filed a complaint against Mayor and KMC of failing to prevent sewage to this river? What is the prime drinking source of the people living and around Ichalkaranji?
Ichalkaranji is a village which is around, it's a small town which is around 20 kilometers down Kolhapur. And it's a fact that the sewage from the city, and not only the sewage from the city, there are a lot of sugar factories, there are a lot of distilleries on the banks of the river Panchaganga. There are around 165 odd villages whose agriculture runoff and the chemicals and the solid waste and the liquid waste of these villages also goes into the river without being treated. And the Kolhapur Corporation also has been facing litigation, has been facing action because of this issue. So from 2009, we went in for approvals from Government of India under the National River Conservation Directorate program, and we got a STP approved for 76 crores, and where the 70% funding was coming from Government of India and 30% was being put by the corporation. Luckily, we could find a PPP partner. In a public-private partnership, we could get a private investor to put the 30% of the share of the corporation. And it's being done on a BOT model. We are almost at the last stage of completion. By this December, it will be fully operational. It will be partially operational from September 2013. So we have already taken a shutdown, and the last stage, which is the pumping station, is being put up. So once the STP is there, 90% of the sewage of the city will be treated. Mm-hmm. That means, you know, the release from the STP will be almost river standards, for river standards, which can directly go back into the river. And that's our part of the work we had to do, and we are committed to completing it in time. But it's just not the Kolhapur Corporation. It's all those, unless all the villagers and all the sugar factories and the distilleries, really, if they don't control all the pollution going into the river. Not only that, there are around 65 KT wires which obstruct the water, free flow of water. And what happens is, because of that, you know, the pollution also accumulates at many points in the river. So that also affects the entire, you know, mission of the pollution of the Panchaganga River. We are making our efforts, this one is everybody else, the other components who are polluting the river should also be equally held responsible. And they should be able to complete the pollution control activity within a limited time period.
What are your hobbies and interests?
Yeah, after coming to Kolhapur, I started learning the guitar. I get to play golf also, because there's an army golf course there. So right now, it's difficult to manage two hobbies also, but I'm able to play the guitar and I'm able to play golf. Okay.
And do you miss Mumbai life?
Not much, you know, because Kolhapur does have most of the things what a city can provide. But at the same time, see, it's a smaller picture, and Mumbai, everything is in a bigger picture. So you're looking more at a policy issue, you're looking at something what's happening at national level or at the state level. So you miss the buzz of Mumbai, you know, because everything is very happening in Mumbai. So which doesn't, Kolhapur is a small, quiet, you know, peaceful place.
Could you please tell me about your family?
Yeah, I have two children. I have a daughter who is 8 years old.
Okay.
And my son is 4 years old. They are studying in school in Kolhapur. My husband is posted as SP in Satara. So he has also finished 2 years there. So it's been going on.